What's up? It's me, DWC, and today I'm going to be bringing you 5 teams that you need to try out in franchise mode in MLB The Show 20. Now, some of these teams are going to be rebuilding teams. I think there's 3 teams that are more so rebuilding teams, and then I have 2 teams that are going to be teams that you're going to be contending with and trying to get deep into the postseason. So I'm going to hop right into it, and I'm going to bring you our first rebuilding team, which is the Miami Marlins. So here we are with the Marlins, and the thing about the Marlins is they're probably the worst team that I have on this list, which makes them a bit more of a challenge. But if you go in here and you look at their pieces, they have Jonathan Villar, which is a solid second baseman. His hitting stats aren't the best, his fielding is decent, and he can get some stolen bases for you with his speed. And he has that high overall, so you can flip him for a trade if you want. Corey Dickerson's a good hitter in franchise mode. Brian Anderson's got A potential, and he's solid even to begin with. And then after that, they don't have a whole lot. But if you go and sort by potential, you see you have J.J. Bleday, who is very solid, 22 years old, A potential. He's got solid base stats to begin with. And then you look at Tyler Kolek, he's a relief pitcher, A potential, he's not that bad. You got Connor Scott, 20 years old, 65 overall, A potential outfielder. Good fielding stats, good speed. If you get that hitting up, he'll be solid for you. And then you have, here's the part where you can make some moves. You have Luis Brinson, who's A potential, but he's 25 years old and 62 overall, so he's never going to get to that A potential. And his hitting stats are absolute garbage. He's a piece you can trade away for some value. You move down here, Monte Harrison, same thing. His hitting stats are a bit better, but his fielding's not good at all. He's a piece that you can move away for some value at 24 years old with an A potential, but only 62 overall. And you still look, if you look at the outfield, we still have 3 A potential right fielders. We have another A potential center fielder, along with Victor Mesa, who's a second A potential center fielder. And then left field, we don't have any potential outfielders. But center field, you have 2 A potential center fielders. And then right field, you have 3 A potential right fielders. So if you're building for the future, you still have a lot of outfield potential. And if you move Luis Brinson and Monte Harrison, you can definitely bring back some value into your team. I'm going to go off and find a trade that I can show you that'll bring a nice package back into the team. Okay, so this is one trade package I came up with for the Miami Marlins. You can tweak these trades if you want. You can look for other options that you would prefer. But keep in mind, with the Marlins, you're definitely playing long-term on this rebuild. You're not going to turn them into a contending team right away unless you trade away your like good young pieces like Connor Scott and Brian Anderson and VR and stuff like that. And even then, you're going to struggle to turn it into a solid contending team instantly. So I went with Monte Harrison, Luis Brinson, and then BJ Lopez, who's a B potential catcher. And in return, we're getting Casey Mize from the Tigers, who is a good A potential pitcher. You look at his stats, they're solid to start off with. He's got that hard fastball. All of his per nines look pretty good to start off with. He's going to grow over the next 2 seasons and then be MLB ready for you easily. And then we're also going to get potential closing pitcher Joe Jimenez. You look at his K per nines, really good. Everything else needs a little bit of work, but he's not far off of being a solid reliever. And for this team, he's going to come in and be an immediate impact bullpen arm for us. Can probably go right into that closing pitcher role for us if that's what we want to grow him as. And then I also just threw in Brian Garcia, who's a 24-year-old B potential reliever. So that's the trade we're going to go with. That's one trade package I found for the Miami Marlins. We're going to make that trade just to put it through. And then I'll be back in another minute to show you the next one. Alright, so here we are with trade number 2 for the Miami Marlins. In this trade, we're including starting pitcher Caleb Smith. He's 28 years old. His stats are not very good. He's only 74 overall. You look at his per nines, they're not very impressive. His hits per nine is good. His K per nine is good. But then everything else is not the best. He's 28 years old, so he's not going to get much better. His stamina's not great. I'm not a fan of him in franchise mode, so I'm going to move him on, and he has a decent bit of value, more than, say, Jose Urania. We're going to move him on. We're also going to trade Magnus Sierra, and then a random first base C potential guy. We're going to get back two relievers with B potential in Faria and in Claudio. And then we're also going to get another outfield potential guy, Tyrone Taylor, who will probably come in and just be your starting outfield. He's not the best center fielder. In fact, he's not very good at all, but he's better than what's on the roster, so he can come in and grow for you in center field. Obviously, this team has a lot more B potential guys and a lot of A potential guys that I showed you in right field, so you can build more packages off of this. But in my opinion, this is a good team with some good base trade pieces to use if you're looking for a rebuild franchise in MLB The Show 20. And I'll be right back with the next team. Alright, so team number two is the San Diego Padres. And when we're looking at their roster, you see they have lots of A potential players. They have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 players that have A potential and are under 25 years old. So, obviously you're not going to keep all of those players. You can keep probably 6 or 7 or 8. But you can trade away a few of them and definitely bring in some pieces to help your team. You go over here, you see they have two A potential catchers. I'd rather go with Luis Campusano because he is pretty much the exact same overall. He's 3 years younger. His stats are pretty identical. Mejia just has better arm strength, and Campusano has a little bit better fielding, and his contact is very, very slightly better. I'd hold on to him, trade Mejia. And then you look at the pitchers, you have Adrian Morejon, you have Chris Paddock, you have Mackenzie Gore, you have Patino, you have Ryan Weathers. So you don't need all of these pitchers, because if you sort it by overall, you have Chris Paddock, who's solid already. You have Lamet, who you can probably hold on to. You have Lucchesi, who would be a good fifth starter for your team. So you go down here, you'd want to hold on to Mackenzie Gore, because he's the best out of the bunch. You'd also probably want to hold on to either Morejon or Patino or Weathers, but you don't need all three. So you can flip one of those into a trade package and bring back something else that would help your team. And then you look and you see we have also more A potential players in shortstop CJ Abrams. Obviously you have Fernando Tatis Jr. He's set at shortstop. You don't need anyone else. Then you have Taylor Trammell in left field. He's nothing special, so you can trade him away because you have Tommy Pham. Frankie Cordero's B potential, but he's not very special. He's not going to be very good for your team, so you can trade him away. Trent Grisham also, he's a good fielder, but his hitting stats aren't going to be that great. He is 23 years old, so he can grow for you. You can keep him or trade him. That depends on what you want to do. But just looking through that, you can see that this team has a lot of options going forward that they could use. So I'm going to come up with a quick trade package to show you what you can come up with for the Padres, and then we're going to move on. I just wanted to show off how much potential this team has, so you can definitely make moves and get the team better, but I'll be right back. Okay, so here we are with a trade package for the San Diego Padres. Now you look at the players we're giving up. We're giving up Frankie Cordero, CJ Abrams, who's 19 years old with A potential, but obviously you want to hold on to Tatis Jr., so you don't need the second A potential shortstop unless you move him to second base, which you could do because second base isn't that stacked. So what I might actually do is take him out and I'll put in Jerks and Profar instead. And I had Cal Quantrill in there because then we don't have to get rid of any of our A potential pitchers. But I will take him out and I'll put in one of the A potential pitchers because you have four pitchers that have A potential that are 20 years old. So getting rid of one of those isn't going to be the worst. We'll just look at the K per 9 and see who we want to get rid of. I'll go with Ryan Weathers. So we will take out Cal Quantrill, put in Weathers, and we'll just look at the trade packages that come back. You get Mancini, who's a good hitter. Michael Chavis, who's a good young hitter. You get Xavier Edwards, who's a shortstop with A potential, who's great. Michael Kopech, A potential. You can get Sean Manoah, who's a good pitcher already with A potential, 28 years old. He still might grow a little bit, but he'll definitely come in and help your team immediately. But yeah, those are some of the trades you can get from the Padres. Obviously, you can throw in more A potential guys if you want. You can use other pieces like Cal Quantrill and Frankie Cordero, like I'm using here. And you can build your own trades, and there's definitely a lot of room to improve this team very easily. So I'll be back with the next team, which is going to be the Seattle Mariners. Okay, so here we are with the Seattle Mariners, and you look at their team. Starting pitching, they need a lot of help. They have George Kirby, who's a potential. They have Justin Dunn down here, who's 24 years old, a potential. You can hold on to him if you want. I'm not sure if I would do that, but then you go down further, you have Justice Sheffield, who is a potential, but he's not very good. Like, he's never going to get to the point where you want him to be a top two arm or a top three arm in your rotation. The bullpen isn't too bad for a team that's in a rebuild. You got Carl Edwards Jr., who I'm a fan of. He had a rough year last year, but before that, he was a solid, solid reliever. And you have Hirano, who's going to get worse very quickly. You got Adams, who's not bad. You look at those stats, he's a solid reliever. You got Altavilla and Sam Tuiviala. Those two guys can grow a little bit more for you. Closer, you don't have anyone right now. Catcher, you have Tom Murphy, who's decent. Don't need to worry about that right away. Then you have guys behind him who can get better in Kyle Raleigh and Leonard Berry anyway. First base with Evan White coming up, you're all right there. Second base, you have a lot of options at second base that are B potential or better. I'd suggest maybe holding on to Shed Long if you want. If not, you can trade him. You see, this team also has a lot of A potential players. We have JP Crawford, who's not very good, 25 years old. He's never going to be a star player in your team, so you can trade him away very easily. Definitely hold on to Jared Kelenic. Kyle Lewis, you can probably move on because he's 57 overall at 24 years old. But yeah, that's the breakdown, and I'll show you some trade packages for the Mariners very quickly. Alright, so here's a trade with the Mariners. We're giving up Sam Haggerty, who is a B potential second baseman at 25 years old, 66 overall, but we also have 1, 2, 3, 4 other potential second basemen. We're also giving away JP Crawford, who, like I said, it's not great. He's not going to be great. You have Nolevi Marte, who's already way better than him and will end up being way better than him because he's 18 years old. Give him 2 years. He'll be your starting shortstop for another 10, 15 years easily. And we're also throwing in Kyle Lewis because he's 24, 57 overall. I don't think he's going to get to the point where he's going to be a star outfielder for us. And we're going to get back Sonny Gray, who is a solid starting pitcher, which we desperately need right now on this team. And then we're also getting a B potential third baseman in Jonathan India. You look at his base stats at 22 years old. They're very solid. Couple seasons, he'll be ready for the MLB as well. So we're going to put that trade through, and then I'll come back with another one. Okay, so trade number two for the Mariners. We are giving up Connor Sadzik, who is not very good. He's 27 years old, B potential. He's never going to be in your rotation. We're giving up Patrick Wisdom, who is A potential, 27 years old. Again, nothing special there. He's never going to get to his potential. This is a common theme in this episode. You're taking players who have A potential and who are 25, 26, 27 years old, and you're trading them because they're never going to get to the point where they're going to be star players for your team. So we're putting in Patrick Wisdom. And we're also adding just Eric Swanson, who's a B potential reliever at 26 years old, 60 overall. In return, we are getting, now this is huge in my opinion, Tyler Glasnow. You look at his stats last year, he was amazing. He only pitched in 12 starts, but he's got that A potential at 26 years old. He can definitely grow and be a star pitcher for your team and come in and help you out right away. And then we're also getting a good reliever in Oliver Drake, which this team desperately needs as they do not have a closing pitcher. You can put Oliver Drake as your closer. You can put Carl Edwards Jr. as your closer. Do whatever you want, but it'll definitely help your bullpen in the long run. So you make that trade, and already this team is looking totally different because you now have Sonny Gray and Tyler Glasnow in your rotation to help you out. So that's two very good arms that you picked up alongside Marco Gonzalez and Taijuan Walker. So that's a decent four in your rotation. And then you also picked up Jonathan India, who's a good potential player for you. And you didn't give up any of your main building pieces for the future in Jared Kelenic and Julio Rodriguez and Nolevi Marte. So you're in a good position going forward with this team. So Seattle Mariners are number three on the teams to use in franchise mode in MLB The Show 20. Next, we're going to be getting into some contending teams. All right, so our first contending team is the Chicago Cubs. We look at the roster. They got decent pitching. They could definitely use another pitcher in the rotation to substitute for Tyler Chatwood, because that's not a very good fifth starter. And they don't really have the firepower up top. So they could use another starter. Their bullpen is okay. Catcher, they're set. First base, they're fine. They could use a second baseman. Maybe move David Bodie to second base or use him as your backup infielder. Then you got Javi Baez, you're set at short. Left field, you got Kyle Schwarber, so you're fine there. Center field, you could use an upgrade for sure. And then right field, you have Jason Hayward, who is really good at fielding. He's got that big old contract. So you can either trade him or move him to center field if you want, so he can be your good fielding center fielder. And I'm going to show you a couple trade packages I put together with the Chicago Cubs. So we are going to be sending Ian Happ, Justin Steele, and Noel Cuevas to the Twins for Luis Arraez, Max Kepler, and Brent Rooker. You look at Ian Happ, his hitting stats are good. He's got good power versus righties, but he's 25 years old. He's only 73 overall. I'm not sure that he'll get higher than 80 overall, so I'm totally fine with trading him for Max Kepler, who's a much better hitter all around. And then we're giving up Justin Steele, who's a pitcher, is 24 years old, 54 overall. His per nine pitching stats are absolutely garbage, so he's never going to make it to the majors. And then we're just throwing in Noel Cuevas, who is a very below average outfielder. And then we get back Brent Rooker in return, who is a potential left fielder, 25 years old, B potential. He can grow a bit for you. And we're also getting Max Kepler, who's 27, B potential, 84 overall. You look at his hitting stats, they're very good all around. Contact versus right could be a little better. Power versus left could be a little better. But overall, they're very solid hitting stats. And he's also a good fielder. So you keep him in right, move him to left, put him in center. He can play any outfield position you want. Very happy with that pickup there. Brent Rooker, and you're also getting Luis Arraez, whose contact stats are through the roof. 99 versus right, 73 versus left. He's a hitting machine in franchise this year. His fielding's not the greatest, but at second base, you don't really need a great fielding second baseman. So that's the trade we're going to do. Definitely improving the team instantly right there. As you now look at, we have Max Kepler and Jason Hayward there. Almora Jr. is not going to be there long. Second base, we now have Luis Arraez instead of Jason Kipnis. I would definitely prefer Arraez over Kipnis. And now we're going to look at the next trade package. All right, so second trade here. We're going to the Rockies, and we're picking up a guaranteed great pitcher in franchise mode this year in Herman Marquez. You look at his starting stats, good. B potential at 25 years old. He's only going to get better. He always pitches very well in franchise mode this year. We're giving up Jarrell Cotton, who is 27, and he's a B potential, 69 overall. Totally fine with letting him go. Nothing special there. We're giving up Almora Jr., who at one point was looked at as a high potential center fielder. He's 25 years old. He hasn't really done that much lately. Last year he struggled. He doesn't have much pop off the bat. He's not the best fielder in center field either, so we're fine with letting him go. And then Mark Zagunas is just a throw-in. He's a nothing player. Never going to make that major league roster. And we're getting back a very solid pitcher in franchise this year in Herman Marquez. So we're going to push that trade through. And then you look at our rotation. It will be Hendricks, number one. Darvish, two. Marquez, I'd put number three. And then Lester and Quintana. And then you got Chatwood behind him, which you can move if you want. Some of these big contracts, you're going to have to do something with them. maybe get rid of Kimbrel and bring Moro up to close your games out. But overall, I think we definitely improved the team with these trades, for sure. And I'm going to quickly move Hayward to center field and show you the difference that it makes. And then we are going to hop on over to our next contending team. So Jason Hayward is an 80 overall in center field, very good fielding center fielder. And you have Max Kepler in right field now to replace him. So you got Schwarber, Kepler, and Hayward in your outfield. That's not too bad right there if you ask me. Hopping over to our next contending team now, it is going to be the Oakland Athletics. And this might be my favorite team out of them all to use in franchise mode this year. We're going to take a quick look at the roster. You see, starting rotation, they need a bit of help. They have Shamania, Chris Bassett, Mengden, and Montas. These four aren't that bad, especially these back two with the B potential. They can get better, and they can be 4 and 5 starters for you. Totally fine with that. Chris Bassett being a back-end starter also isn't that bad. Shamania right now is our ace, so we need another pitcher to put in with these four, because I'm not confident in Mike Fiers. And Jesus Luzardo, I don't think, is quite ready yet. Give him a little more time in the minor leagues, in my opinion. And if you wanted to, you could put Luzardo in the rotation and then just take Montas out and put him in the bullpen or something like that. But I think we definitely need another starter. The bullpen's fine with Soria, Petit, Wendelken, and Trevino, and Diekman. I'm fine with that. Hendricks as a closer, very good right there. Now, catcher is one of the main spots they need to upgrade, as they have Austin Allen, who's 26 with B potential, and Sean Murphy, who's 25, but only 66 overall. So you can definitely make an improvement here at catcher. First base, you're pretty set with Matt Olson. He's one of the best first basemen in this year's game in franchise mode. Second base, you could use some help, as you only have Tony Kemp. Could definitely use an upgrade at second base. At third base, you have Matt Chapman. You're set. You have Sheldon Neuse behind him, 24 years old, 72 overall B potential. His hitting stats are decent to start off with, and his fielding is good. What we're actually going to do is move him over to second base and let him be our second baseman. So you see, he's about the same as Tony Kemp, but I think I'd rather him because he's younger and he can still grow more. So we'd have Sheldon Neuse at second base for us in the upcoming season. And then we have shortstop Marcus Semien, solid, with Robert Poisson behind him. And Logan Davidson, you could also move one of them to second base if you wanted to. They don't have the secondary positions, but let's be real. Anyone who plays shortstop can play second base. And then the outfield, you have Chris Davis, Chad Pinder, Robbie Grossman. Nothing special. Chris Davis is obviously a DH. And then Pinder and Grossman, nothing special there. Then you have Ramon Laureano and Mark Canha in center field, and Steven Piscotty in right field. So I'm going to come up with a couple trade packages here for the Athletics, and then I'll be right back. Okay, so here's trade package number one for the Athletics. We're once again going back to the Twins for a trade partner. We're going to be giving up the A potential catcher in Sean Murphy. You see, his power's not very good. His contact's not that great. It's okay for a catcher, but his fielding isn't even that good. He's just got a good arm. We're getting back, in return, Mitch Garver as our catcher, who had a breakout year last year. The year before, he didn't even do that bad, but he had a breakout year last year with 30 home runs, 995 OPS. He's not the greatest defensive catcher, but he's definitely a good offensive option at catcher. He's one of the best offensive catchers in the game this year, so we're going to be picking him up. And then we're also giving away Franklin Barreto. No power, no vision, no discipline, no clutch. Fielding isn't even very good, so no problem giving him up. He's 24 years old, 65 overall. He's not going to get much better, in my opinion. Never going to be an MLB starting second baseman, in my opinion. And then we're giving up another A potential player in Dylan Thomas, who's 27 years old, but only 64 overall. He's a good fielder. His hitting stats are garbage, so we're fine with giving him away too. And then we're also getting back Max Kepler to go in there for our outfield. So our outfield will then look like Steven Piscotty, Ramon Laureano, and Max Kepler, along with Chris Davis at DH. So we're going to pull the trigger on that trade. That definitely improves our team. And I'm going to come back with one more trade for the Oakland Athletics. Okay, in this trade, we are giving away Chad Pinder, who is an outfielder for us. B potential at 28 years old. His hitting stats are very average. He's a really good fielder, so you could take him and move him to center if you wanted to. But in my video, we're going to be using him as a trading asset. We're also giving up Seth Brown, who's 27 years old, 67 overall, B potential first baseman. He's not going to get a whole lot better. And then we're also throwing in a C potential third baseman just to make the value match up. And in return, we are getting back John Gray. So he's 28-year-old starting pitcher. This team needed another starting pitcher, is what I pointed out. Pretty solid attributes to start off with. 82 stamina. His hits per nine aren't the greatest. Got good K per nine. Decent walks per nine. His home runs could come up a bit, and his clutch is pretty good. So overall, he's a good starting pitcher, and he always seems to turn out to be a good pitcher in franchise mode as well. So we're going to be picking him up, and then we're going to be looking at the team with those two moves that I made. Only two moves. You look at our rotation now. Manaea, Gray, Bassett, Mengden, Montas, already better. Bullpen we didn't touch. Mitch Garver at catcher now is a huge improvement. Matt Olson, Sheldon Lewis, Matt Chapman, Marcus Semien. And then in left field, we are going to put Max Kepler in left field, or Stephen Piscotty in left field, I'm not sure. I think I'll leave Piscotty and I'll put him in left field instead. And then we'll leave Max Kepler as our right fielder. Because you see, Piscotty jumps up to a 79 overall now. He's another player who's underrated and also seems to hit well in franchise mode. His hitting stats are pretty average, but from my sim experiment that I did the other day, he always seems to hit pretty well. And then we have Max Kepler. So our team is already a lot better, as you have Chris Davis as your DH, Piscotty in left, Laureano in center with Canha behind him, and then you have Max Kepler in right field. So I think that team is definitely a team that can go into the postseason, and if you're good, if they play well, they can go on a little run for you. That's probably my favorite team to take over in franchise mode with those moves. I think they can definitely be improved fairly easily, and they can definitely turn into a winning team. Maybe if you wanted to, you could pick up one more starting pitcher for this team, and then I think that you're pretty much set. But there you have it. Those are my five teams, my top five teams to use in franchise mode this year. I highly suggest you try them out. Play around with them a little bit. Make some trades, make some moves, improve the teams, and just enjoy yourself in franchise mode. Try these teams out. And hopefully you'll enjoy them. Hopefully you'll find out that they're good to use just like I think they are. But that'll do it for this video. I'll see you in the next one. Peace.